Okay. We're about to begin the finals of the Philadelphia City Championships. Frank Diaz on the left and Sean Zhang on the right. Frank Diaz with Mulligan, revealing two double colossus, a plus power, a dark patch, Juniper. The plus power Sean saw is very important when it comes to the Mewtwo Wars. This will allow Frank Diaz to knock out a Mewtwo at 2 energy just by having a double colossus and a plus power instead of committing the third energy, forcing Sean to have the third energy on his Mewtwo coming up to revenge kill Frank Diaz's Mewtwo. I do not believe Sean plays plus power, so this will definitely assist Frank in his Mewtwo Wars. Frank told me he did play three double colossus energies in his deck. Okay. Okay. Looks like Sean's going first, starting with Mewtwo and a Trubbish to Frank's Mewtwo. Okay, so Sean attaches a fighting energy and an EV light. And Ultra Ball's away a energy switch and an Ultra Ball. Sean's gonna take a moment to see what's prized, what's in his deck. He grabs a Landorus EX. And he passes, showing that he doesn't have a supporter. A very weak hand. Let's give Frank Diaz an opportunity to take advantage, go aggressive. Frank's gonna attach a Eviolite to his own Mewtwo. Gonna catch out Sean's Landers. Play computer search. Discarding two cards. I cannot see what those are. But computer search is a very powerful card. Discarding two cards from your hand, allowing you to search your deck for any card in your deck. Add it to your hand. You do not need to reveal it since your deck is private information. And you could get any card with this. Frank's gonna play a plus power and then a Juniper. Benching a Darkrai and I'm not sure what that other card is. He attaches a double colossus to Mewtwo. He's going to X-Ball for 50. Sean evolves to Garbodor and passes. Includes another Mewtwo on the bench, and I believe he benched another Darkrai. He's gonna Bianca. Frank going aggressive, knowing that Sean's hand is very weak, he has no supporter. He didn't play any cards at home. So Frank's gonna go aggressive and try to just put on more damage on board. He's gonna X buff a 40 after, I'm not sure if it's an energy or an EV light. minus an energy on the Mewtwo on the bench. Shot top decks off fighting energy. He's deciding whether or not he wants to attach the fighting to Landorus. Doing that, see how much damage X-Ball would be doing if he attaches the fighting. X-Ball does 20 times the number of energy attached to defending and the Mewtwo. Double Colossus counts as 2 energy, so that's 40 for the 1 Double Colossus. It's going to Hammerhead, doing 30 to the Mewtwo, so 10 to the Mewtwo, and then 30 to the benched Mewtwo, thanks to the Eviolite on the active. Frankston is Skylar for energy switch. He's gonna catch her up. Sean gives you energy switch. Such a dark energy, and he's going to X-Ball for knockout 200 damage, taking the first prizes of the game. Sean plays Tool Scrapper, discarding Frank's Eviolite. He's gonna Hammerhead the active Mewtwo and the benched Darkrai for 30 each. Did also discard a Darkrai and another card I did not see. Gets a Roselia. Just double goals to the Mewtwo and plays it Professor Juniper, discarding. I think that's an end. Attaches an experience share to the Mewtwo. It's a neat little tech to this deck. Keeps energy in play. And he's going to X-Ball, knocking out the Landorus. Sean can, and Sean scoops, knowing that he cannot avoid the knockout. So Frank Diaz will win game one. It's a very rough game for Sean. Not have a supporter. Just couldn't seem to catch a break. Whereas Frank just went aggressive with his Mewtwo, eventually knocking out Sean's own Mewtwo. And then just taking poor control and then the game. So Sean's gonna decide if he wants to go first. I assume he will. There's no reason not to. Hopefully this game will be more eventful. Sean will get to actually play the supporters. Now Garbodor's an interesting card in this matchup. It shuts off Darkrai's Dark Cloak ability, which grants every Pokemon with Dark Energy free retreat. He has Landorus and Terrakion that have a 3 retreat cost and a 4 retreat cost, respectively. Dark Cloak shut off, and Frank not playing any switches. Sean can catch her up Terrakion or Landorus, and just hit them both for 30, hit the active for 30, and then spread to the bench. And then just keep putting on pressure, knowing that he cannot retreat. I'm not sure if Frank plays Tool Scrapper or not, that would be a very, very key card in this matchup. It seems like players today just seem to not include Tooscrapper in their list. And as a handshake, we're going to begin game two. Frank Diaz will mulligan. Okay, so game two starting. Sean sets a Mewtwo to Frank Diaz's Landers, EX. Sean attaches a double call as energy. Sean plays a Skylar, so he does have a support in this game. He's gonna grab an N, showing that his hand is actually fairly weak. He's gonna grab a supporter. So, Sean either has a very weak hand or a hand he does not want a Juniper away. It's very common this situation occurs where you have a Juniper and a bunch of cards you do not want to get rid of, like multiple catchers, etc. So, you try to fish for the N. Sometimes you have to play the bullet, play the Juniper, but in this situation, Sean's gonna go for the N, wait a turn, and then play N to refresh his hand. An X ball for 40. Frank is gonna play Ultra Ball, Scrying a Dark, and then N. Getting a Darkrai. And plays an N. Frank is going to attach a Dark Energy to the Landers EX. He's going to pass his turn. Sean fetches a Drubbish. Thank you. Sean contemplating on what to discard for this Ultra Ball. Looks like he's rid of, ooh, two card reserves. It's a Landers, yes. Yes, he's hoping that the other Landers is not prized. Or that he plays a Super Rod, which will shuffle those cards right back into his deck. He takes up to three Pokemon and energy. A combination of the two. And shuffle them into your deck. Benches Mewtwo and the Landers. And attaches the fight energy to the Landers. And plays a Sharon in three. No, that's a Bianca. Sorry. Excuse me. It's a Bianca for six. Attaches EV to the Mewtwo. Sean will catch her up the Darkrai and play the switch. He is going to Hammerhead the Darkrai for 60 and then 10 to the bench. Frank Diaz plays like a Pure Search, so he grants him any card in his deck. Didn't get a good look at see what he just took. He's gonna play a Dark Patch to the Darkrai. Plays a plus one and a Juniper. Touch the fighting edge to the Landers. Okay, he's gonna Hammerhead, but 30 on the Mewtwo on the bench, while doing 30 to the active. Sean attaches a double colorless to the energy with Mewtwo with damage. Attach a experience rate to the Trubbish and catch her up the Darkrai with 2 energy on it. Sean's gonna play a Ultra Ball, discarding a Fighting Energy. He grabs a Garbodor. He benches second Landers. Let's go to Hammerhead for another 60, and then 10 to the Mewtwo on the bench. I mean, the Landers on the bench. Frank is going to Ultra Ball, discarding a Skylet and something else. I'm not sure what that other card is. Figure that one out. Okay. So Frank gets Mewtwo. One of the cards in Frank's deck was upside down when they were doing a deck check. One of the judges accidentally left one of his cards upside down in the sleeve. There's no harm about it, just leaving it as it is. Except my energy switch out the Yonker for 6. There's an Eviolite, which is going to prevent the Linus from knocking it out with Hammerhead. And he's going to Night Spear this turn. Catch the Landers without energy, and it's going to Night Spear that one. He touches up. Fighting to the Terrakion on the bench. Okay, he's in 90. Okay, and then he can do 32 Landers. Night Spear does 90 to the active, and then 30 to a bench Pokemon. Sean has a computer switch. Yes, he has a computer switch. Discarding an Ultra Ball, and I'm not sure the other card. Grabbing the switch. Again, doesn't have to reveal the card, but I guess since he's going to play it, it does not quite matter. Sending up to me too. There are X balls for the knockout. Bring some sort of track in with the fighting energy. While he needs energy, he'll be able to retaliate for 90 since Sean just took a knockout this last turn. Catches the dark, and now he's going to be able to retaliate. And he's going to catch up the Landers with 90 damage on it, and then play on N. Okay, so dark touch, dark energy to his dark eye. And retaliate for the knockout. touches experience your 2 Mewtwo. And benches. Thinking about benching the 3rd Mewtwo. Touches a 2nd fighting energy to Iris EX. And then puts an N. Then Alan benches the 32. He's gonna hammer it with 30. And put 30 on the fresh Mewtwo. Drinks and catch up to Mewtwo with no energy on it. It's gonna play a Juniper. Probably fishing for fighting energy to Land Crush. Doesn't look like he has it though. Drink pitches into the Darker. I'll touch the Dark. To the Darker on the bench. He's going to retaliate for 30. Sean only has 2 cards in his hand. Probably not the strongest of hands. He's in a tough position. Mewtwo is stuck active. He needs to either switch or double call us to either attack or retreat. He has to double call us. And then captures the Landorus EX with damage on it. I'm not sure how much damage is on it. He's going to X buff with 40. Now Frank can have an interesting turn here. He has an energy switch in his hand. So you get him to switch the fighting to the Flanders. And if he he would need a lot of cards. He would need another energy switch and a fighting energy to be able to land judgment for 150, knocking out the Mewtwo. I'm not sure what he did. I'm not sure if that's a energy or a tool to the Mewtwo. Has a fighting energy, he's not sure where he wants to attach it. It's actually, it's you and me too. He plays a heavy ball. Into fail search. Not grab anything off the heavy wall. He's gonna X before they're not gonna going down at two prizes. Wants to drag him. Ooh, top decks the energy search. Grabs the fighting energy. What a great top deck. I think the Mewtwo has 60 damage on it. Attaches the fighting energy. And evolute to the tracking. It's going to retaliate for 90. Shun's in a very tough. She's in top deck mode. He has not many cards. He has a small hand. Not much to work with. Doesn't really get a supporter. Try and do some math. Figure out how much damage he's doing with X Ball. Don't press it hard because you're aware to put the energy. So he wants to attach to it, but not there. He attaches it to the Mewtwo and benches. Oh, he top-ticked the Juniper. Oh wait, looks like probably got it off the prize or something because he has a Sharon too. It's a tool scrapper for the Eagle Light. Plays a switch going up to the Mewtwo with 4 energy. I believe that's 4 energy. He's going to X buff, we're not going to go down one prize. Frank pulls the Dark Eye. shoves Lander some bitch threatening up and judgment. Touches the dark. Place the max potion on the bench. I think it's a Mewtwo, I'm not sure. There's a plus power. And hits the Mewtwo for 80 and knocks out the Mewtwo on the bench. Now, if Sean has an energy, he will win this game. He gets a retreat to the Lander's EX and lands Judgment, discarding all his fighting energy and knock the Darkrai EX out. Grabs the catcher, catches up the Mewtwo, and takes game two. Very close game. Could have gone either way. Okay, so we're gonna go to deciding game three in the Philadelphia City Championships. Frank Diaz will probably be going first in the last game. The round has been going on for quite a while. I'd imagine time will be called soon. Oh, really? Okay, looks like... How much time do you have? Huh? Okay, apparently there's around 20-25 minutes left in the round. So that means this game probably will be fully played out. Game 1 didn't take much, very long at all. Game 2 kind of dragged on, but you still have a good 20 minutes left in the round. Handshake. Going on to game three. Okay. Frank will start with Mewtwo. To a Landorus EX and a Trubbish on the bench. Plays an Ultra Ball, discarding a Dark Energy. Okay. Ultra Ball's for a Darkrai. Dark Patches to the Darkrai. He also benched another Mewtwo and then plays an N. Touches double colors to the Mewtwo, and then that catcher for the Trubbish to knock it out turn one. Diaz takes an early 5-6 lead. Sean has a fighting energy. Attaches an Eviolite to the Landorus. Sean plays a heavy ball. Grabs the Landorus EX. Isn't also what's going on fighting, and I'm not sure what the other card was. And gets a Mewtwo off the Ultra Ball. And then plays an N. Attaches a... takes it back. Attaches... Experience Share to the Landorus EX on the bench. And then Hammerheads on Mewtwo and the other Mewtwo. The Skyla. The name's Gold, and I'm gonna be the best. I'm not sure what that was, but okay. Grabs computer search with the Skyla. This computer search is creating two darkness energies. Grabs a dark energy with the computer search. He's going to X-Ball for 60. 80 minus 24 of the Eviolite. evolves into Garbodor. Plays a Skyla. Grabs a Pokemon catcher. Catches up the Darkrai with 2 energy on it. And hammer it for 60 out of Darkrai and 30 to the Mewtwo with the Eviolite. 10 with the Mewtwo with the Eviolite. Touches the Fighting Ninja and plays Bianca. Gets 6 cards off the Bianca. Bench of the Lander, CX with the Experience Share. Benches, I think that's another Darkrai. Spear for 70 to the Lander, 60 Eviolite, and 30 to the Mewtwo EX on the bench. Sean attaches a... Nope, he takes it back. Attaches double colors to the Lander CX and plays a Juniper, discarding the fighting energy. This is a very intense game, very close. Either player can win at this point. Catches up the Darkrai without the energy. Okay, he is 60 to the Darkrai and 30 to the Lander's EX on the bench. Touch a double colossus energy to retreat. Deciding on who he wants to retreat to. Okay, so gonna knock out the Lander CX with Night Spear and then 30 to the bench Lander CX. Experience share. Sean puts the energy for experience share. Experience share allows you to get when your active Pokemon is knocked out. You can attach one of the basic energies attached to the knocked out Pokemon to the Pokemon with the experience share attached. Attaches double colors energy to the Mewtwo. Plays a super rod. Shuffling back in Landers and two fighting energy. And then plays an N. Sean benches out Lander CX. Sean uses Lance Judgment for 80, knocking out the Darkrai that had damage, keeping the energy in play. Frank has used the experience share because the fighting energy that was attached to Darkrai and attaches it to Landers. Plays a Pokemon Catcher for the Mewtwo EX. Benches a Darkrai EX. Was a plus power. And X balls for not going down to one prize. Sean plays an Ultra Ball, discarding a Garborder. And a Bianca. It's a Mewtwo. It is Ultra Ball. Touch of the fighting energy to the Landers. And plays an N. The dreaded N to a 1. Frank will only draw one card off of this. This is one of the scariest situations to be. Have a close game like this and your opponent and you to 1. You can only hope to top deck supporter over exactly what you need to win this game. Frank only needs to take one more prize to win the game. Sean Tetch rescue Scarf to the Garbodor, finally getting a tool, locking Frank Diaz's powers. It's going to land Judgment for the knockout, discarding all the energy. Now my friend gets off fighting energy. The game ends here. He can discard both fighting energies and land Judgment for the knockout. It doesn't look like he has it since he's still contemplating his move. Would promote. This is very, very close. Game will probably be decided next few turns. Landers. Oof, draws into a dead card. Attaches a double call with energy to the Mewtwo. And he's going to Hammerhead for 30 and then 30 to the bench landers. Sean's playing on Skyla. The look on his face tells me he probably has to win this turn. Let's see. Gets the energy switch. If he has the energy, he will. Yes. And land Judgment for the knockout. Sean Zhang wins Philadelphia City Championships in a very close set, 2-1, with Garbodor, Mewtwo, Landorus, who get 50 championship points, and I believe 18 packs of Boundaries Crossed. Well, Frank will get, I believe 40 championship points, or 30, I'm not sure. Huh? 40? Okay. So yeah, he gets 40, and a second place finish at the Philadelphia City Championships.